Ladies and gentlemen, it's my great pleasure to welcome you to this, the 2019 University of East Anglia graduation ceremony. And the purpose of this ceremony is to confer awards on candidates from the School of Computing Sciences and the School of Pharmacy. And it's been a really great year for both schools, with some fantastic examples of student success. I'll give you a few examples. In the School of Computing Sciences, student Maria Ford at the recent Norwich Think the City Startup event won the judges' prize for leading a team to develop an app to remove the uncertainty around recycling and to influence consumers' long-term behavior through educating individuals and helping households reduce their environmental footprint. And another comp student, Isadora Platoni, did her final year project with West Suffolk Hospital, developing a clinical photography dashboard, which is now deployed as a key component of the hospital's clinical systems. Very innovative. The School of Pharmacy saw the first cohort of students graduating from our BSc in Pharmacology and Drug Discovery. In fact, we're going to see them graduating today. And one of our first-year MPharm students won a national competition, the Rickett and Benkisser Responding to Systems Competition 2019. And the school's MPharm and MPharm with Placement courses have received accreditation from the Pharmacy Board in Malaysia, showing the global reach of this school. And also, we have huge global reach in the School of Computing Sciences. I could say much more about these two wonderful schools. They both have magnificent research achievements as well. But time isn't going to allow me to do so. But I would like to take this moment to express my thanks to my colleagues in both of these schools for everything they've done and achieved over the past year. Many thanks to you all. But graduands, sitting at the back of the arena there, today is your day. It's about you. It's a moment to celebrate your achievements. But it's also a moment to reflect on your experiences at UEA. So do please savour this moment. You've worked so hard. You have earned it. So do take time to enjoy it. And I know that your families and friends have come from all over the world to be here with us today. A very warm welcome to you all. And I want to thank you for all of the support and encouragement you've given to our graduands. Without your support, they really would not be with us today to celebrate their achievements. You really are so important to them. So thank you very much. And graduands, please know this. We here at UEA are very proud of you as you prepare to graduate from us. I know that your families and friends are all very proud of you, and I can tell you that the city of Norwich is very proud of you because you add so much culturally to this wonderful city of ours. So I think that you can be very proud of yourselves. And your graduation today is the sum of many, many parts. Your education has been a truly collective endeavour. You have done all of the heavy lifting, but at every step, there's been a supporting cast of literally thousands to help you on your way. From the day you first wheeled your suitcases onto our campus or brought your heavy rucksacks with you, from the minute your parents decanted your life's belongings from the boot of a car, to actually getting robed up for today's ceremony in these wonderful robes that you're all wearing, the UEA staff have been there as your enablers. There as your educators, there as your supporters. And so, as your Vice Chancellor, I would like to thank all of the staff of the university in this arena and across the campus for all their endeavours on your behalf. The staff of the university, thank you all very much. Now, wherever you came to UEA from all around the world, I think you chose very wisely when you chose to study in Norwich and at UEA. Norwich is the city of stories. It's a city of literary firsts, the first UNESCO city of literature in this country, the first creative writing course in the UK, and the home of the National Centre for Writing. And I think that in many ways, today is the culmination of the UEA chapter in your life stories, Whatever degree you've studied, you are now forever part of Norwich's story, and Norwich is forever part of your story. But now it's time to go out into the world and write your next chapter. And as you write that chapter, please think about your time at UEA. Reflect on what you've achieved at UEA. And of course, savour your favourite moments here. And as you now look forward, please don't be daunted by what the future holds for you. There is no doubt that these are difficult times. And I believe that we will need all the energy, all the passion, all the intelligence of your generation to help some of the problems our planet faces. Some really, really great problems. But you'll do so with our support. We need you to help to keep us on the straight and narrow. We actually need you now more than ever before. But I'm confident that in your hands, our world does have a bright future. And thinking about those futures in your own personal futures, some of you may have a very firm plan for your future. Others may not. And some of you might think that not having a plan counts as a very good plan. Now, whichever camp you're in, you'll find that your life will deliver surprises to you. There'll be strange twists and turns. And you need to be prepared for that. Certainly, my life has delivered me a few surprises. And so I'm going to let you into a little secret. Way back in 1981, almost 40 years ago now, I applied to UEA to be an undergraduate. But unfortunately, they rejected me. I got a little slip of paper saying rejection. Clearly, that was a bit of a setback at the time, but you have to pick yourself up. I went to other universities. And then, 10 years later, I applied to join UEA again, this time as a lecturer. And this time, they accepted me, which is rather nice, on a 3-year fixed-term contract. That was 30 years ago. They didn't notice I was still here. So stories do have strange twists and turns. And you can imagine that 40 years ago, when I got that rejection slip, I would never have imagined I would be standing here on this stage in these fine orange robes and this floppy hat about to hand you, to award you, your degrees. So, my advice to you would be believe. Believe in yourselves and you will succeed. You will get setbacks, you will get knockdowns, but continue to believe, and you will be successful. UEA's taught me a great deal. It's made a big difference to my life. So also, remember what UEA's taught you and try to continue to make a difference. Take some risks, be brave, and perhaps always remember our motto, do different. But please, above all else, be kind. This sometimes cruel world needs kindness now more than ever, and I do sometimes feel that kindness is becoming a much underrated quality. Now, some would say that looking forward and predicting these days really is a fool's game. But I'm going to brave a few predictions. I'm going to predict that in years to come, you'll look back at UEA, at your time at UEA, and remember some of the following things. You may remember the ziggurats and our wonderful lake, the UEA Broad, sun-kissed in the summer or snow-capped in the winter. Maybe the Sainsbury Centre, a genuinely iconic building, home to a world-class art gallery, and also, of course, the headquarters for the Marvel Avengers in those Hollywood movies. Yes, they really were filmed here on our campus, or some of them were. The castle, the cathedrals, the medieval lanes of what is one of the most beautiful cities in the country. You remember the knowledge and the skills you've gained, the extracurricular opportunities you've had with students' union clubs and societies. And perhaps some of you will remember Derby Day, the annual sporting fixture where UEA students once again comprehensively defeat their University of Essex counterparts. And we did it again this year. Yes. You remember the friendships that you've made, and these friendships will endure for a long time, and they will prosper. And then, of course, you will remember, I'm sure, this wonderful campus and its many thousands of rabbits, the UEA bunnies, as we call them, our mascot in many ways. And, you know, I think the rabbit here, the UEA rabbit, actually has a Twitter account. It's on social media. And I must be the only vice chancellor in the country, if not the world, who's followed on Twitter by a rabbit. And I'm probably, therefore, the only vice chancellor who actually also follows a rabbit on Twitter. Yes, I follow the UEA rabbit. But that's UEA for you. It's a unique environment. It's a different environment. It's a special environment. And I hope that our visitors today have had a chance to experience that environment and will continue to have a chance to experience that environment very soon. And you're always welcome to come back and visit us anytime. Now, graduands, in just a few minutes, you're going to become UEA alumni. We're going to welcome you into an extended family of 140,000 UEA graduates from all across the globe who've shared experiences very much like your own. Our alumni really is a family of nations. We like to call it UEA's very own United Nations. We have alumni from 191 countries from around the globe. So do please keep in touch with us. Make use of our alumni network because it can serve you well in your future and it will help you continue the friendships that you will value throughout your lives. And also, please, remember that graduation from UEA is not a simple goodbye and good luck. We remain here for you as your enablers and as your supporters for all the rest of your lives as you write those next chapters in your life's journey. So in a moment, I'm going to hand the floor to our graduands. They're going to process across the stage and receive their awards. And please, all of you, all of our guests, do remember this is a celebration. They really have worked hard. They've done incredibly well. So it's a moment to let them know that. Feel free to make a really huge amount of noise. Applaud, whoop. Make sure that they get a sense of just how much we value what they've done. And help them to celebrate. So, UEA graduands, this is your day. Please do enjoy it. Thank you very much.
I present to you candidates from the School of Pharmacy for the Award of Degrees. The degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Gerald Roman Sean Keel. Shirley Christine Mills. Serena Monaco. Remy Thomas Narosny. Caris Louise Thomas. Grace Walden. The degree of Master of Science by Research, Hazel Nicole Moxham. The degree of Master of Pharmacy, Hayden Ray Victor Lance Abbott. Ali Abdul Majid. Mariam Onene Abdul Malik. Joseph Stanley Adams. The Rosemont Prize for Molecular Pharmacology and the Royal Pharmaceutical Society Prize was awarded to Gabrielle Adewumi Monilola Adkola. Joseph Achmani. Selassie Christine Ayepong. The Alumni Prize was awarded to Mohamed Al Hassan. Ishmael Kale Ali. The LPC Prize was awarded to Aya Saad Alomari. Sikanda Amini. Caroline Antonios. Christine Antonios. The School of Pharmacy Prize for Best Pharmaceutical Research Project was awarded to Michael Morgus Asad Ayub. Evie Leah Yani Bannister. The LPC Prize was awarded to Joshua Burrows. Carolyn Yi Ling Chang. Si Yao Stephanie Chu. Colleen Mary Duffy. The LPC Prize was awarded to Georgia Eagleton. Mariam Eas. Elizabeth Rose Everingham. The Rosemont Prize for Medicines Management was awarded to Emma Diane Fielding. Hannah Elizabeth Jewett. Rebecca Jones. The LPC Prize was awarded to Deslava Milkova Kaneva. Jasminda Kaur. The Rosemont Prize for Drug Delivery was awarded to Agni Kuraiti. Hailam Kwan. Hoi Chung Kwan. Sehin Kwok. Ving Ye Lai. Lao Zoming. Hoi Ting Luong. Hung Yan Jung. Ming Chuck Lee. Maria Luigina Liu. Panashi Dorcas Mabesa. Fuad Olamidi Mahamud. Connie Yuan Ting Mang. Rebecca Mansfield. Rianne Sarah Maffer. Serena Jade Matthews. Manuela Ioana Mitroy. Adrienne Eloise Moulton. Zainul Hafiz Masuki. Michael James Murphy. Shadi Musa. Sarah Naeem. Madison Louise Neal. Grace Babafunga Dimitopi Bimisola Nitufo. Onyedika Chukwu Chimaobim Michael Ingubi. Ugo Chukwu Jimmy Eloto. The Andrew Thompson Prize was awarded to Courtney Ella Preston. Sam Sadat Farisani. Carenza Louise Smith. Risha Solanki. Eleni Solomu. Bongai Sester Michelle Takavarasha. Hung Fai Zhang. Diana Vojvodina. Alistair John Watkinson. Emmanuel Olayinka Williams. Abigail Wharton. Diane Wu. Ji Jie Sang. Te Weisang. Olipa Sulu. The degree of Bachelor of Science, Charles Burgess. Emily Beth Hobson. Ugne Obonaiti. Gabrielle Wilson. Veronica Nabil Helmi Abdul Youssef. From the School of Biological Sciences, the degree of Bachelor of Science, Joseph Silch. From the School of Environmental Sciences, the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Eleanor May Warren Thomas. From the School of Education, degree of Bachelor of Arts, Sarah Farah Ruhumutali.
You are now UEA graduates. You are the class of 2019. John has already got everyone to raise a round of applause for you. So that's what I was going to do. You've been doing my job. But let me give you my personal congratulations. You are about to set off on a really very exciting journey. Now, as UEA graduates, you are also UEA alumni. And that puts you in that group of 140,000 UEA alumni, that family that is UEA, the global family. But there is a catch, just a little catch. And that is that as UEA alumni, your vice chancellor, i.e. me, occasionally asks for a favor of you. So I'm now going to ask for a little favor of you. I'm not going to waste any time, coming straight in there as new alumni. What I'd like you to do, first of all, new UEA alumni, is to all stand up, please. Just the UEA alumni, if you would. Thank you very much. It's very kind. Now, we have congratulated a lot of people this evening, this afternoon, but sitting in front of you and sitting to the side of you are your families and friends who have made such a huge difference to your lives, contributed so much. Without them, you would not be there today with the successes that you have. And I know you can make some noise, so let's hear you make some noise for your families and friends. The families and friends. Now then, I'm going to be naughty. I'm going to ask for a second favour, so please stay standing. This is actually the last graduation ceremony of the week. It's number 19. Around 6,000 UEA graduates have now passed across this stage this week. And none of the successes, none of your successes, none of their successes would be possible without a particular group of people. And earlier on, I mentioned some fictional superheroes, the Marvel Avengers, who generally do have their fictional headquarters on this UEA campus. But in reality, there are thousands of real superheroes on this campus, and that is all of the UEA staff. Without them, you really wouldn't be here celebrating your successes today. And actually, as we come to the end of this week, we have to say also, as a group of those staff, a special thanks to the graduation events team, who've looked after us and organized us so well for all of these events and who are in the arena today. So what I'd now like you to do is to raise a rousing round of applause, all of us please, for all of the UEA staff, so they can hear you all around the campus, the UEA staff. Thank you very much. You can sit down again now. Thank you. Whew, it's hot in here, isn't it? We are coming to the end of this graduation ceremony and to the end of our graduation week. So it just remains for me to wish you all well on the journeys that you're about to embark on. Those journeys are going to take you all over the world. But please, no matter how far from UEA you go, please do stay in contact with us. We do want to know about the achievements that you make, and you're going to make some amazing achievements. I'm really confident in that. So please do keep in touch with us. I wish you the very, very best. I now declare this congregation ceremony closed. Thank you very much.